Now I've got, I just finished a purple painting, can you tell? I've got the Folk Art Pure Gold. This is from Target, Handmade Modern, new penny. This is Martha Stewart, Vintage Gold. This is Golden Pearl. I add just a little bit more. Add a little bit of water. They've been sitting here just for a little while. Saying, pour me, pour me, pour me, pour me. Metallic bronze, artist locked. So those are the two. Martha Stewart, this is from Target. Folk Art. This one is Black Pearl by Master's Touch. And it almost looks like it has a little bit of gold and gold iridescent pearl essence color in it, but I added silver to it to knock it down just a little bit so it's more like a kind of a goldy pearlescent dark pewter to black range. So I've got about 18 ounces of paint. I think I have enough to do a 16 by 20. So this is 16 by 20. It came black from the store. Putting the push pins in the corners. I was going to pour on a white canvas, but I think with the metallics, black would be more interesting. And instead of putting down a layer of black, which I don't want mixing in by any chance, what I'm going to do is spritz the canvas like I did on my last painting with the purples. Just trying something different. Isn't that funny how it's bubbling up? All there is water in here. I do have a squeeze bottle of black in case I need it for the edges, but I may leave some black negative space. So here's my, I don't know if this is 10 ounces or what it is, but I'm going to fill it to the brim. So I'm going to do the pearly black first. And then I'm going to go with kind of a, oh, goodness. I just about forgot. Coconut, OGX coconut milk. All the colors are mixed with Oetrol Easy Flow. One part Easy Flow Oetrol to two parts paint. I wanted to add just not even a full pump to just three of the colors. So I'm doing it to the black, the new penny, and the bronze. I almost forgot to do that. Okay, so there's the black and then the palest champagne color. I want a lot of contrast between the colors. I'm going to stick in the stick and stir just once or so. Okay, so now I've got a wet canvas that's just damp from water. I'm going to do a flip cup. I want to save some of each color, so I'll just do that. I don't guess there's going to be any black negative space, huh? Utilize my paint. Maybe I should have used just straight out black for some contrast because it's pretty mellow considering. See, my canvas is already dry. I want to make sure that paint flows. It's all very muted. Interesting. So I guess by going with lighter and darker contrasting, I ended up making it more muted than maybe if I'd have gone from like dark to light. I'm just curious. I do like this thing going on here with copper going through it. It's kind of pretty and kind of not. It needs something for sure. So I'm thinking I will pour like a ribbon through it of some sort. So I've got these little baking loaf pans. Before I do this though, I'm gonna water down my paint because I want this to be more fluid. I'm going to use what's left of my deeper colors. I'm not going to use the lighter ones. I am going to put the heat gun to it real quick. So I'm going to take a small cup, put some black in it, copper, a little black, some of this brassy color. I'm going to throw in a trickle of white. And this pearly black and some black again, and then this I'm gonna put a pump of, not even a pump, kind of like greasing up a baking pan. That stuff smells so good. Smells good. I'm not even a coconut fan. So I'm going to do black. Oh, drop my stick in. I don't want it to be even. I want it kind of layered in bits and pieces. Thinking more copper is going to come out. Now, I like this, so I don't want to disturb that. This is really bland here, and I don't like this area. Now, isn't that interesting, because I put the coconut milk in here how it came out so leopardy, not leopardy, reptilian looking. That's interesting. Okay, now I gotta put a little half pump. Ooh, that's pretty. When in doubt, play. Okay, that didn't sound good.
What was that?
My heat gun.
Is it broken?
I don't know, but...
Guess I need to go find that other one, huh?
So there's not a lot of paint on the sides, even though the canvas is black. So I can always go in after it's dried and paint the edges black or gold or, you know, whatever color. So not, and you drop your stick in the paint. The key is to not keep a straight line where it fell. I'm trying to make sure the canvas does not show through anywhere on the top because I was shy of covering it. That's the death of a heat gun. Does not smell good either. So that one is toast after 4 or 5 months of painting. But I have a heat torch if I have to use it. Ooh, that stinks. My paint smells good because it's got the coconut milk, which smells delicious. I really like to get a little bit of dark. Through here. Just for some contrast. Okay. I'm going to call this one done. Low spot on the canvas, so I need some paint to thicken that area because it was down to the canvas a little bit. Kind of different. If I take it out from under the big box lights here, it looks gorgeous in the regular light from the kitchen and living room, that kind of thing. Very rich and very metallic-y, so hopefully it'll dry that way and put some varnish on it, glossy varnish, and really make it pop because the metallics are just totally gorgeous when you give them a clear coat. So if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.